In this video, I'm going to help you understand the iPhone's Control Center. This is a handy tool that gives you quick access to important settings and features on your iPhone. I'll explain what it is, how to open it, and how to personalize it to suit your needs. Plus, I'll share a tip on how you can set it to be accessible only from the home screen and not from within the apps, which is great if you enjoy playing games. Now, just a heads up, this video was recorded on my iPhone 15, and it is running iOS 18. Not so much the iPhone itself, the iPhone 15 really doesn't matter, but with iOS 18, Apple changed how you edit the Control Center. So if your iPhone is using an older version, the editing part of this video and a few other features that I will show you may not apply. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's get started. Let's take a look at the Control Center on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. First, let's take a look at what it is. So I'm going to go to my Control Center, and I'll tell you how you can access it shortly, but I'm just going to swipe down from the upper right-hand corner. This will get me to my Control Center. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit. But this is the Control Center here. So what is this? Well, basically what you have is access to different controls or different features. As an example, if I wanted to open up the calculator, all I have to do is just tap on this control here, and it'll open up the calculator. Or maybe what I'd like to do is go into low power mode. I tap on this control here, and it'll put my iPhone into low power mode. I'm in dark mode, but maybe I'd like to go into light mode. I tap on that control, and it'll take me into light or dark mode, toggles it. Or if I want to set a timer, I can do that as well. So these are all different controls. We have screen brightness here, and I even have media controls. So basically, it just gives us quick access to these different types of controls. And there are a lot of controls that are available. So that is what the Control Center is. We just have quick access to various tools or various features of the iPhone. So now how do we access it? I'm going to go back over to the home screen. So I just tap where there is no control here, and I'm looking at my home screen. So now I'd like to access my Control Center. Well, as you saw, if you have an iPhone with Face ID, all you need to do is just flick from the upper right-hand corner. Now, why did I say flick? Well, if you swipe all the way down, it's going to go through different controls. We have different pages with the Control Center introduced with iOS 18. So if I swipe all the way down, what it's going to do, let's go ahead and do that. I swipe all the way down, and you're going to see it's rotating through all of my different screens on the Control Center. I don't want it to do that. So I find that the easiest way to get to the Control Center is just do a little flick here, and that'll take you to the first page. So I do a little flick, and now I'm looking at the first page. If I want to go to another page here, you can see I have two pages here. I just swipe up, and I can go to another page. I swipe back down, brings me back. So doing the little flick here is much better than swiping all the way down. That's how I used to access the Control Center. And then all of a sudden, I saw it rotating through those screens. One other thing I want to mention when we access the Control Center. When I flick from this area here, it will take me to my search. I really need to flick or start from the very top. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start from this area here and go down and watch what happens. It takes me to my search. What we really need to do is we need to make sure that we place our finger in the upper right-hand corner where our battery is, where our Wi-Fi is. And then when I flick down, then it'll take me over to my Control Center. So start in this area here, and then just do a little flick. What about an iPhone with a home button? You're going to have the home button down here, and then the display is going to be above it. Well, all you need to do is just swipe up from the bottom of the display, and then it'll go to the home screen. I'm sorry, it'll go to the Control Center. So you swipe up from the bottom of the display above the home button, and then you'll get to your Control Center. So that's how we access our Control Center. Now let's take a closer look at this Control Center and how we can edit it. We can customize it for our phone. To do that, we go into our Control Center. So I'm just going to flick from the upper right-hand corner. I'm at my Control Center. Now what I would like to do is I would like to customize this. I want to move some of these around. Maybe resize a couple of these controls. Well, in order to do that, what we need to do is go into the edit mode. There's two ways to do this. I can tap and hold in this area here, anywhere where there is not a control. Or what you can do is just go up to the plus here, and it'll put it into that edit mode. So I'm going to tap on the plus, and we're in the edit mode. So now what I'm able to do is drag any one of these widgets here around to rearrange them. I can even drag these up here, which you couldn't do prior to iOS 18. So if I wanted to move my connectivity tools down here, all I have to do is just drag it down to the bottom there. I want to place it back up to the top, I just drag it, and I place it back up at the top. I can do the same thing with these controls here. I just drag it down towards the bottom there. So we can easily move our control center, our controls on the control center. Another thing we can do is we can resize them. You're going to see that there's this little arc here in the lower right-hand corner of most of the controls. If it has that little arc, that little bold corner, what you're able to do is drag that to resize it. So I'm going to move this one over here, and then we're going to resize it. So I just drag it and place it over there. Now I'm going to take this little corner here and drag it. And when I do, it resizes it. I'm going to drag it back, and it brings us back. So let's just keep it large there. And then, of course, we can easily remove controls when it's in this edit mode. To remove control, we just tap on the little minus. So that's the low power mode. Let's go ahead and remove it. It is no longer there. So now we know how to move them around. We can resize them. We can remove them. What about adding them? To add them, when we're in our edit mode, what we do is we tap on add a control. And then when I tap on that, we have all of our different controls. And there are a lot of controls in here, far more than what we had available prior to iOS 18. So I just tap, or I scroll up to view all of the different controls. And we do have third-party controls. You're going to see that I have here a couple of third-party controls there. So a developer can put a control in here for their app as well. If you want to search, which is what I would recommend, you tap on search. Why do I recommend that? Because of the sheer number of controls. It just makes it a little bit easier. But you can just swipe up to scroll through all of the controls. So I removed that low power mode. Let's go ahead and add it back in. So I'm just going to tap on search, and we're going to go to low, and you're going to see we have low power mode. I want to add that control back. Tap on it, and you're going to see I have my control back. And again, I can resize it to make it a little bit larger if I want. Let's just keep it at that size there. And we're going to drag it back up here. And now we have my low power mode. So now we know how to move them around, how to resize them, how to remove them, and even how to add controls. Well, once we've done that, how do we get out of this edit mode? All you do is just tap in an area where there is not a control. So I can tap there. I can tap up here. And when I do, it puts it back into the standard mode. It's no longer in the edit mode. To get back to my home screen, I just tap again there, or I can tap up here. And when I do, it brings me back to my home screen. Now, I mentioned earlier that with the Control Center, we have extra pages. This was introduced with iOS 18. What do I mean by that? Well, remember when I said if you swipe all the way down, it's going to go through the Control Center pages there. You're going to see that it's switching between different pages. To view those pages, what we do is we just flick from the upper right-hand corner. Make sure that you flick from the top. And then when you do, what it does is it takes you over to your favorite controls. So this is where you want to place your favorite controls, the ones that you access on a regular basis. And then if you want to go to the other pages, you just swipe up and you can go to the other pages. In addition to that, we can edit those. So how do we do that? We go back into the edit mode. So I'm just going to tap and hold in this area here. I'm in the edit mode. And now when I swipe up, I can edit that control, or that page, I should say. I swipe up, and I can go and add more controls to this page. Each one of these little circles here is a place for a control. So as you can see, you can have a lot of controls on here. And all you have to do is just tap on add a control. Again, when you're done, you just tap anywhere, and it takes it out of the edit mode, tap again, right down here, and it takes you back to your home screen. Last thing I want to show you is how you can limit access to the Control Center. Right now, it's available through any app. So I can go into the clock app as an example. And when I do, if I want to get to the Control Center, I just swipe down or flick down and I'm at the Control Center. So I can do this from within any app as well as the home screen. Well, some apps, particularly games, will have gestures. So if you flick up there for a gesture on a game, what is it going to do? It's going to go into the Control Center. So what you need to do is you need to turn that off. You need to turn off access to the Control Center from within that app. Well, basically what we're able to do is set, if we want the Control Center to be available only on the home screen, so we can tell it to be off on all other apps. We can't tell it for a specific app, but all other apps. How do we do that? Well, we just go into our Settings app, and then we go over to Control Center. And under Control Center, this is where you used to edit the Control Center prior to iOS 18. Well, now the only option we have within here is, or we have two options really, we can access within apps, and this is going to be on by default. When this is on, I can access the Control Center from within any app. So if I wanted to get to the Control Center, I just flick down from the upper right hand corner. Even though I'm not on the home screen, I'm at the Control Center. But let's say you are playing a game and that is conflicting with that game. Well, then what you want to do is you want to turn this off. When you turn this off, the only place that the Control Center is going to be accessible is on the home screen. You're going to see that I cannot access that Control Center. But when I go to the home screen and I flick down, I'm able to access that Control Center. So if you turn that on, I'm going to go back over to my Settings app. If you turn this on, it'll be accessible. The Control Center will be accessible from within any app. Turn it off only from your home screen. And then if you want to reset it, you can reset it as well. Why would you want to reset it? Well, actually, by default, there are three pages to the Control Center. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this back on here so that I have access to it. And when I swipe down, you're going to see that I have two pages here. Actually, there are three pages. There's a media page, and what I did is I removed it. How did I remove it? I went into the edit mode on that page and tapped on the minus. So let's go ahead and get rid of this one here. And now that is no longer there. So I only have two pages. So how do I add those back in? Well, I could go down to add a control and find them. But if you just want to start over, like I erase those accidentally, what you may want to do is reset it. So I'm going to swipe back up. And I'm going to reset this, and it's going to reset the Control Center. And now when we go back, you're going to notice that I have my favorites here. And then when I swipe up, you're going to see I have three pages here. When I swipe up, there are my media controls. It looks like an iPod. And then when I swipe up again, I have my communication. And if I was in edit mode, I'd be able to swipe up again and create my own screen for my own controls. So that's why you may want to reset it, in case you deleted something and you're not sure how to get it back. That's what I found, how to get these back here. The communications, the networking controls, as well as the music controls. The only way that I figured out how to get those back is by resetting it. So that is our Control Center on the iPhone. Basically, all we have to do is just swipe from the upper right-hand corner. I say more of a flick. You don't want to swipe. And then you going to be able to access various controls on your Control Center. To edit this, we just tap and hold in any blank area or the plus in the upper left-hand corner, and then from there you're able to resize them, remove them, move them around, and even add more controls. When you are done, just tap in a blank area again. So that is the Control Center on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can share it with your friends and family, you can subscribe to my channel. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I have or host classes on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member of my site, danstutorials.com, I take out all of the ads from the video, so you're not going to see any ads. You have access to that AI assistant, modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me out of a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.